second that.
We have a motion to second to approve the minutes. Any questions, comments, corrections? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Crisp?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item three is citizen participation on agenda items only. Anyone has questions or comments on agenda items, please come forward and state your name for the record.
Kat Stone, Roseburg. I have a question about item number six. What is the dollar amount, and how does that benefit the citizens of Winchester Bay or the greater population of Douglas County?
Okay, anything else? Seeing none, move on to item number four, public health. Good morning, Dr. Van Hout.
I've got a couple of public health before you. Amendment 12 to our LPHA agreement that provides funding for next year.
I'll move for the intergovernment agreement amendment. Mr. Freeman.
I'll second that.
We have a motion to second. Any questions or comments?
Just a quick comment if I may.
Sure.
So this is sort of our annual big contract. Throughout the year, we've been amended several more times. But outside of that, I wanted to take just a minute and thank the doctor and his team over at Douglas Public Health Network for all the amazing work you've done. And we haven't had a lot of public meetings to have this chance to thank you. We are continue to be one of the counties that is doing some of the very best work, innovative work, including these test clinics. Most other counties are having their hospital and health systems do testing, and we continue to provide availability for testing outside of that healthcare system. It's pretty innovative. And I heard rumor that you may be going to help one of the other counties sort of do one of these so they can learn a little bit how to do it.
That's correct. Marin County has had a big outbreak among their Pacific Islander population, and they really need a lot of help in setting one of these up. So two of us are going to drive up next week and try to help them out.
So thank you for the work you're doing here and around the state. I know you're also on the governor's medical panel, and you've got about 14 hats now. So thank you for all that great work.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. We have a motion second and a few comments. Call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Crisp?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item five, ordinance authorizing the grant. Thank you, Dr. Van Hopper. Mr. Meyer.
Yes, Paul Meyer, Douglas County Council's office. So the title of this ordinance is an ordinance authorizing a grant to Infinity Foundation. This is ordinance number 2020-05-02. The first reading was 2 weeks ago on May 27. Today's the second reading. If you adopt the ordinance today, it'll have an effective date of September 11, and the ordinance authorizes the county to give a grant to the Infinity Foundation for a community ed building project.
So nothing, no action item?
It is an action item.
I think I'll move to approve the ordinance authorizing the grant.
I'll second that. Motion second. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Crisp?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item six is a commitment letter. This is a letter from the board to the Winchester Bay Sanitation District committing to pay for an engineering study. What this is about is when we plan the RV resort expansion in Winchester Bay, we had to close our dump station out on the east. The reason for that was when the sanitation district gets large, sudden disbursements of the RV effluent that has that blue stuff in it that hit their system all at once, it can cause a problem with the way that the organic material in that system works. So in order to ensure that they didn't have a problem with that, we agreed to close that dump station.
So Sin Harbor RV Park?
Right. So what we'd like to do is reopen that dump station. So there was a study called the Dyer study that was done in 2012 that listed some alternatives that we could implement over there in order to get that back open. There was three alternatives. One of them included putting a tank in the ground and having the tank capture the effluent from the RVs and then just have some septic system, you know, service company come and pump the tank and haul the stuff off. And we could do that. It just doesn't make sense long term. So the concern is that we have a considerable amount of interest in that community and RV parks. They've got a fairly new septic system that's designed to handle
decided with them that it would make sense to take a look at the system as a whole, where all the RV effluent's coming from and when, and determine what the best way to deal with that would be. And we suspect that the study will come back that there's some sort of a holding tank needs to be installed somewhere within the system, and that a controlled flow of that RV effluent into the sanitation district's going to be what's required. And we'd just like to have that professional opinion before we start to do that work. So this is an agreement with the sanitation district for us to pay for that study.
So it's my understanding that the county is the single largest customer for the Santa Barbara Sanitation District.
Yep, by a long shot.
And I also understand that the county has a great history of working with the district, and I think even the facility may be on county property, and community block development grant administration, and a whole bunch of history of making sure that that community, as well as the RV parks, has a good sewer system to use, and whatever we do there will be to continue to improve that system for all the citizens that use it in that area, right, and the RV parks.
Right.
Okay.
And my plan is to take this letter to their board meeting, which I think is on the 11th. I think it's tomorrow night. I'm not sure. Anyway, and present the letter to them, talk to them about what the plan is. I've been speaking primarily to the district manager, Ray, and see if we can get something going with that. Make that work.
I'll move to approve the letter of commitment.
I'll second.
Any questions? Further comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item number 7 is a communication service agreement. We got Tom Cross on here, but good morning, Sheriff.
I'm not sure how that happened. Good morning, Commissioners. John Hanlon, Douglas County Sheriff. This item before you is a communications agreement between Douglas County and the Fair Oaks Rural Fire Department, or Fire Protection District, for dispatch services and radio feeds. It's a 3-year term beginning last July 1, ending June 30th of 2022.
Move to approve the service agreement.
Second.
Any questions or comments? None. Call for a question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item 8 looks very similar, Chair.
It is. Exactly. It's the same thing. It's a communications agreement between Douglas County and the Elkton Rural Fire Protection District, again for dispatch fees and radio fees.
Move to approve that service agreement as well.
I'll second that.
We have a motion to second. Any questions or comments? None. Call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item number 9, another service agreement.
Yes, this one is between Douglas County and the Tri-City Rural Fire Protection District for dispatch and radio fees.
To approve the service agreement.
I'll second that.
We have a motion and second. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well.
Thank you.
Sheriff. Item number 10 is a delegation order. This is actually a delegation order delegating me the authority to work with the state of Oregon on issues related to the DHS and OIA contracts for the juvenile department. I am the liaison commissioner for the juvenile department now. We've been in talks with the state of Oregon over the last several weeks leading up to our new budget year about their contracts. And they need to have a single point person designated in order to have that conversation. So that's what this delegation order is about.
So I'll move to approve the delegation order.
Motion second. Any questions?
Just a couple of comments. So up until now, I've had this delegated authority, and I've been so the beginning of the year, I was the liaison that you went on department and worked with them through some contractual issues last year, much like what you're going to need to now. This is an important program, taking care of foster youth from all over the state of Oregon, and having one person for the state to deal with here is really just an efficiency thing, so you don't have to come back to the board over and over and over. The board's been very clear through our budget process and through other public meetings what our goal is here and what we have to accomplish, so I'm sure you're quite clear on where we need to be and feel very comfortable with doing that work.
Call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item number 11 is a parks grant agreement. Mr. Houston, good morning.
amendment to the County Opportunity Grant Program 18-002, which was for Windy Cove Loop B restoration work. A couple items were removed from the scope, and the grant, the project was reduced $25,000, and the grant project, the grant funding was reduced by about $10,000, down to $92,000. Initially, we thought we had it approved. We put in fencing instead of landscaping because we it was better for our user, and it was tentatively approved, but then management at State Parks disagreed with those early discussions. And given the all the grants that we were working with, it was the best solution to kind of conceded before.
We approved the grant agreement.
I'll second that.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Brady?
Aye.
Commissioner Brown?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item 12 is another parks item, agreement extension.
So this is an extension, the third extension between Douglas County and the Winchester Bay Rural Fire Protection District for services through June 30, 2024 for all of our park facilities in Winchester Bay.
I will move for the agreement extension.
I'll second that. Questions, comments?
I would just note that I don't think it increases the amount, but I think we have decreased the liability quite a bit, taking out some of the trailers and stuff. And
yes.
Some of those old single white trailers and people living there all the time. So.
And putting an all new electrical in there definitely reducing our workload, if nothing else.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item 13 is Parks Order Authorizing Purchase.
So this is an order authorized purchase of a 2020 Ford F-450 dually super cab with a Nappide. When I look at it, I can't say it, but anyways, Nappide 9-foot dump body bed. This is part of a grant with the ATV program. The total purchase price is $65,849. We're utilizing an existing purchasing agreement through Sourcewell. It was out embedded. Noticed here locally. The grant is for $52,000. We're providing just $13,849 of county funds for this transaction.
Move to approve the order authorizing the purchase.
I'll second that.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Item number 14 is the planning item of committee reappointments. Good morning, Mr. Shackley.
Morning, Commissioners. Joshua Shackley, Douglas County Planning. For you, it are the reappointments of Jennifer Bodenhammer, Robert Bullock, Brian Tranquil to the Emergency Medical Services Advisory Committee through November 30th, 2022, and Gary Garisi, Benaris Petty, and Brian Burke to the same committee through November 30th, 2021.
I'll move to approve the reappointments.
I'll second.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item 15 is another planning item. Public hearing, Mr. Shackley.
Joshua Shackley, Douglas County Planning. Thank you. Before you this morning is a hearing and order incorporated territory, an owner initiated annexation into Douglas County Fire District Number 2. Chief petitioners are Anne Marie and Ryan Lee Parkhurst. Subject property is located at 16178 Dixonville Road, which is about 2.5 miles southeast of Rosewood City Limits. Zoning on the property is FG, that's our exclusive farm use grazing zone, and is about 163.48 acres in size and does currently include a dwelling. Planning department finds this annexation complies with county comprehensive plan and statewide planning goals. We received no objections from the public, and on the part of staff have no objections. Board can open the hearing and take a motion on the order and book the hearing.
All right, open the hearing, see if anyone wishes forward to comment on the
16 is Public Works Purchase Agreement. Good morning, Mr. Adams.
Good morning, Commissioners. Scott Adams, Public Works. This is a purchase agreement from the Finnell Ranch LLC to install and maintain emergency temporary detour bridge on the South Rural Road, milepost 10.71. Purchase price is $861.61.
We'll move to approve the purchase agreement.
I'll second.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item 17, Public Works Contract Agreement.
Again, Scott Adams, Public Works. This is a contract agreement between Douglas County and GE Digital LLC to provide software professional services. The Yellsville Dam quote total is $10,852 for the software and a one-year term for the software support. This is a separate contract from the installation of such software.
Move to approve the contract agreement.
I'll second that.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments?
Could you just give them a quick rundown on what that software does is used for?
Okay, so this is this software is used for the monitoring and management of the Galesville Dam. We have CB Pacific who will be doing the engineering consulting services for the installation. This is to basically go through our iFix program and fix our SCADA system, which is the monitoring of the dam, the energy levels, the valve, the flow rates, and all that comes out of the dam.
Pretty important work here, especially with the summer coming up.
Yes, yes, and this is something that we continually monitor, like it's almost it's lifetime. So our staff here in the office will be monitoring this work as it's hopping from the dam to our computer systems here in the office, so we could be monitoring it and making any changes from here, so they have to go out and make hand changes and do it in a 45-minute drive. So it's pretty critical that we're able to monitor if something happens, we're able to get out there right away and assess the situation.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item number 18 is a Public Works Contract Agreement. Mr. Adams.
Scott Adams, Public Works. This is contract number 3000342 for the government zeros in there. Between Douglas County and Walgreens and Sons for the Douglas County Bridge Replacement Bundle Project number 11017. bids were opened on May 20th of 2020. Walgreens and Sons was the lowest responsible bidder for a total contract amount of $3,295,653.13.
So I'll move to approve the contract agreement.
I'll second. There is a motion to second. Any questions or comments?
Just a couple. So I know this is the engineering portion. This is actually the bridge replacement?
This is the construction portion.
Okay. So have we had experience with this company that's doing construction?
We have not. Not directly with the county. Our consultants have done some projects with them, and they've reached out to other entities and vetted that and done their research, and they're comfortable with moving forward. All
right. And we've got mechanisms in place to monitor progress. I'm not trying to be fussy, but the challenges we had on our last major public works project were frustrating as commissioners, and I want to make sure we're doing what we can to eliminate the bad ones.
Yes. So we always have the good ones and the bad ones, and that was one of the bad ones. And we continue to evolve those contracts, put things in place to mitigate those concerns. But this one will have a consultant inspection on it. So we'll see in the next week or two another CACEI, which is Construction Admin and Engineering Inspection Services contract that will go along with this to help support inspection and the administration of the contract.
Yeah, I thought I saw that floating around. I was mixed up, but yep. I want to make sure that we're
on top
of this one. Like I said, the last one was pretty frustrating.
We have a motion and a second. Call for a question. solid waste contract extension, Mr. Adams.
Scott Adams, Public Works. This is for the solid waste department. This is a contract extension, the 14th extension of contract 22293 between Douglas County and Umpqua Research Company for the reporting and analysis of the sampling required by the Oregon DEQ for the operations of the solid waste program.
To approve the contract extension.
I'll second that.
Any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Press?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Thank you. Item number 20 is a radio communications order authorizing the purchase. Good morning, Miss Laney. You look like a seasoned professional already.
Why, thank you. Good morning, Commissioners. Nancy Laney, IT Director for the county. This morning before you, we have an order authorizing purchase of a 2019 Ford F-150 for the amount of $39,900.
I will move to approve the order authorizing purchase.
I'll second that.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments? Just
comment how important this, you know, that vehicles used to go to all the remote radio tower sites quite often, you know, out in the states before.
That will be the second vehicle for that.
It will, yeah.
Two guys work.
That's right. So we can have social distancing. They can both work and not be in the same vehicle. And we need to have a reliable one, so it should give us years of service. Thank you.
Yes,
it
will.
So, not too long ago, we only had one guy, and the question will be, so this is
a well, we bought a new vehicle for the one guy a couple of years ago, and this is for the second, yep.
Yeah, it's just the length of it. It does give a considerable amount of money and personnel and equipment to make sure that every vehicle system is going to use for
us. We absolutely have to keep that radio system up.
Yeah.
It's a challenge.
Yep. Call for the question, Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Thank you. Item number 21 is a Reedsport Justice Court item of pro tem order. Commissioner Kress.
So for the Reedsport Justice Court, we had an order appointing Ryan C. Connell, which is the Tillamook County JP, to serve from June 4th, 2020 to June 4th, 2021 in Judge Miller's absence over there, and I move to approve the order.
I'll second that.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. If I can get to have the sheriff back. Item 22, intergovernmental agreement extension. Sheriff Hannon.
Good morning again. John Hannon, Davis County Sheriff. This item before you is an intergovernmental agreement extension between Douglas County and the City of Riddle for patrol services in the amount of $153,943 for fiscal year 2020-2021. It represents roughly a 3% increase over last year's agreement.
We'll move to approve an intergovernmental agreement extension.
Second that.
We have a motion and second. Any questions or comments? Seeing none, call for the question. Commissioner Freeman?
Aye.
Commissioner Kress?
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes. Item 23, Sheriff's Contract Amendment as well.
Yes, this is a, this amends the 2021 intergovernmental agreement between Douglas County and the Oregon State Marine Board to provide marine law enforcement services, patrols on all our water impoundments and rivers and lakes and streams. The amendment changes the termination date to June 30th of 2021, and it increases the funding received from the State Marine Board by roughly $13,808 over last year. That agreement pays for two full-time deputies to provide marine patrols, as well as a part-time cadet that assists the regular deputies during the high volume summer boating season.
Move to approve the contract amendment.
Second that.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or comments?
Sheriff, how do you decide which body water that you send those folks to?
It just depends on, you know, the weekend and what type of activities have the most boaters. You know, 4th of July weekends are always busy on, or used to be busy, you know, at Diamond Lake for
the 4th of July festivities up there, as well as Salmon Harbor. So they just try to, you know, make their best judgment at which places are going to have the most volume of boaters.
You can assume whatever you're boating on waterways in Douglas County, we have a patrol person there.
Yeah. And, you know, during the summer months, you know, the Winchester Bay, Salmon Harbor is always busy. You know, any number of the you know, lakes like Loon Lake, Berry Creek, Cooper Creek, those are always busy, you know, with people water skiing and boating. So they just try to make their rounds and get to all of them as best they can.
I've seen them on multiple lakes in a day.
Yeah.
Yeah,
they'll hit two or three different reservoirs in one day. A lot of times, go from Galeville to Cooper Creek and Berry Creek all in one day.
Call for question, Commissioner Freeman.
Aye.
Commissioner Press.
Aye.
Chair votes aye as well. Motion passes.
Thank you.
Item 24 is intermission. It'll take a full 5 minutes. We don't want to give anybody that wants a chance to speak during citizen participation an opportunity to sign up in the back.
The pen doesn't work.
That?
The pen doesn't work.
Okay, I can get you a pen.
Okay.
Scott's got one back there. It worked.
Now it works.
It just probably didn't return.
Thanks.
I do have one off-agenda item if you don't want to go ahead and take care of it. It's the dues for AFC. It's we're going to take off the $15,216 for the federal land subcommittee. That makes it about $45,000, $46,000.
Second, that's Association of Oregon County. Okay.
Questions, comments? Call for questions, Commissioner Freeman.
Aye.
Commissioner Press.
Aye.
Motion passes. Scott, go ahead and bring that up for me. Moving on to citizen participation. I've got one here behind that cat stove. Good
morning. Good morning, Cat Stone. Scott fixed the pen. It wasn't in my mechanical ability. So I have a question from someone else, and it's about the Clyde from Glide auto wrecking area. I heard the county required them to have a visual buffer with trees, but there is another salvage yard north of Roseburg, I-5 northbound, and it does not have any visual buffer. And people feel that it is giving the county a bad name because it's really out there, and it's much larger than the Clyde from Glide site. So they wanted me to ask why the county hasn't required them to have a visual buffer. That's all.
Be a couple reasons for it. I don't know that. One could be that the Clyde from Glide had a different zoning than the other one, and so this was part of a conditional use permit and part of the mitigation. I'm not sure that. I'll have to look into that. I don't know that, but I'll let you know.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I said it. I told him.
I got nothing. Thank you. Meeting adjourned.